So the term betel nut refers actually to a little preparation of pieces of actually a nut that comes from a palm called the areca palm.
So these are the areca nuts.
And the nut is usually a package of pieces of areca nut and some other flavorants, usually wrapped in a leaf. It's the fourth most commonly used addictive substance after, you know, alcohol and nicotine and caffeine. It's really now very well appreciated that it is quite a health hazard in regard to a cancer-causing agent and also other kinds of oral diseases. It's still estimated that at least 300 million people are habitual users. And now you can get it off of eBay in little foil packets in a preparation that's already been cut up and you can just chew. And there have been a number of reports associated with the main ingredient, which is called arecoline, being useful to suppress inflammation. So our first discovery was really related to that.
These are from one of our first experiments with the areca nut.
In my laboratory, we have available all of the clones, which is to say the DNA necessary for us to artificially make all the different kinds of brain nicotine receptors in a system where we can study each type in isolation. And the way to help somebody reduce their craving for nicotine is to put a low-level stimulator of those specific receptors. And that's what the drug Shantex, the one that's commonly used now for trying to help people quit smoking, does. It gives a very low level of stimulation to these so-called alpha-4 containing and alpha-6 containing nicotine receptors. And what emerged from our study of the broad range of nicotine receptors was that the arecoline was just about as effective on those receptors as the Shantex, indicating that Shantex could replace what arecoline was doing to create a craving for the betel nut. It's a brand new idea. By introducing the possibility that it's treatable, maybe we can get more interest in getting support for its treatment. It's not a problem that's going to go away. We've got a discovery here, and we have to realize the potential of the discovery and to better the human condition.